if there's a conflict between the US and Iran, it would be a disaster for Pakistan. Already Pakistan has suffered because of conflict with Afghanistan. The thing that worries us most is that we've just stabilized our economy. We went through a really difficult patch. We've stabilized our economy, and if there's a conflict, oil prices will go up, and not just Pakistan, it's going to affect a lot of the developing countries.
And you brought this up with President Trump.
Yes, I did. The fact that we will all suffer, I mean, the developing world will suffer because of the oil prices. But in any case, it makes no sense. I mean, it's 19 years the U.S. has been stuck in Afghanistan. Can this region afford another conflict?
Did you feel he was listening?
Well, I give my point of view. I don't know. I mean, I guess he will, President Trump would have his own advisors. But I certainly gave my point of view, and I'm really anti these military solutions.
You have been very outspoken in recent months about events in Kashmir, in Indian-administered Kashmir, and it was something, again, that you brought up with President Trump. He's said he's willing to help if he thinks that the United States can help. But when all of this began, when India revoked the special status of Kashmir back in August, you compared the Indian government to the Nazis. You said, will the world stand by and watch like they watched Hitler at Munich? Did you mean to make that comparison?
Absolutely. India at the moment is being run by an extremist ideology, which is called RSS. RSS got its inspiration in 1925 when it was formed by the Nazi Party. They admired the Nazi Party. They admired the racial purity of the Nazis and then the ethnic cleansing of Muslims from India, the way the Nazis dealt with the Jews. This is all you have to do is read the writings of the founding fathers of RSS, and you will know it is an extremist racist ideology which murdered Mahatma Gandhi. He was murdered by RSS. It was banned 3 times in India. And sadly, that's taken over a country of 1 billion people.
This is the organization that is the precursor, if you like, to the BJP party of Prime Minister Modi.
Minister Modi is a life member of this party.
But that is not what we are seeing in India right now. There are clearly nationwide protests. There are Muslims who feel that their identity is at stake. But to many people, the comparison with the Nazis will seem not only far-fetched, but offensive.
All you have to do is read what the founding fathers of RSS said. And remember, whenever this happens in history, whenever you have this idea, you have the nationalist, racist genie comes out of the bottle, and with hatred towards another human community, there's always bloodshed. What is happening in Kashmir is shocking. 8 million people are in an open prison for over 5 months.
But then let me ask you about what is happening in another of your neighbors, China, in the western region of China, Xinjiang, where we have overwhelming evidence over many, many months about the systematic incarceration of hundreds of thousands of Muslims, about re-education camps, as the Chinese call them, about surveillance outside the camp. So where are your public statements on that?
Because, first of all, Kashmir is a disputed territory between Pakistan and India. It concerns us directly.
Okay, but I'm not
because it's my neighbor.
I'm not only talking about Kashmir. I'm talking about the broader point that you are making about Muslims in India about the ideology of the governing party in India. Do you have any concerns about what is going on in Xinjiang to Chinese Muslims?
At the moment, I do not know enough about it. And if I have, we will speak to the Chinese privately. Because that's how the Chinese are.
You do not know enough about it. There have been numerous reports. Some of this is already known from policy documents that are put forward by the Chinese about the building of these camps.
I'm afraid, Michelle, I don't know about it. Because at the moment, our major concern is what is happening to a Pakistani disputed territory between India and Pakistan.
Perhaps you are choosing not to know, because the economic relationship with China is very important to you.
No. Then, I mean, I could be talking about everywhere the Muslims. Just look at it, from Libya to Syria to Somalia to Yemen, I mean, there are Muslims being killed everywhere. So I should be talking about everyone.
So what is the way forward then? Are you hoping that President Trump does get involved, that he takes on some kind of role? I mean, that would, India obviously objects to any kind of what it would see as international interference in its affairs.
Well, at the moment, it's might is right is what India has done. It's violated the United Nations resolution. It's violated similar agreement between Pakistan and India. So if there's no bilateral discussion between Pakistan and India, how is this issue going to be resolved unless and until either the UN gets involved or a power like US gets involved? How else is this going to get anywhere?
Did President Trump tell you he was willing to do that?
Well, President Trump basically said that he will try, I mean, meaning that he will try and speak to the Indian government. Look, the problem is that the way I see it, it can get worse. The way where we stand today, unfortunately, I feel that unless there's some intervention by European Union, by the United Nations, by the United States, I just feel that things will just go from bad to worse.